I'm Kevin Hart, and this is season 5, and we are back to the locker room. And this is the biggest season yet, which is highly offensive to everybody that was on this show before. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Hug it out.
How are you
doing? That's right. I'm good.
Good.
Come around here.
Hey.
You get comfortable. You take your robe off. Okay. Put on the hook.
Yep.
Get into the tub.
All right. I dig it.
Today's episode is going to be quite the doozy. The doozy eye. The double do. That's what I call it, right? See, we sit right here on the back portion of the tub.
Got to.
Ooh. Ooh. I didn't put lotion on my knees.
That's tragic. You can't be out here ashy.
I would ask that if you have any type of judgment that you refrain from using it, okay?
Yeah.
Nothing a little cold water can.
That's going to make it work.
Well, let's not worry about that. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to an all new episode of Cold as Balls. Well, today we got another legend. I feel like the world of legends are getting bigger and better, and they all come through here. Asia Wilson on the show, a legend right now. Let's talk about winning. When did it become real for you? When did you see that this thing was going to be the life?
I started when I was maybe like 13, 14 years old. I was like horrible at basketball. Like I stunk. My dad was the assistant coach and he still didn't play me.
Okay.
You know how bad you gotta be for your own father?
That
not
is bad. That is bad. I'm not even gonna sugarcoat it. That's bad. Fast forward, 15.
Boom.
15, 16, we're good now.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's real. What's the mindset? What's the attitude? We're in high school, you're crushing.
Yeah. I'm like, I gotta make some happen. I'm trying to not have my parents pay for college. So I'm like, I'm putting in the work.
Was that a priority?
Yeah, like that was big for me because my parents sacrificed so much for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, you know, this is the least I can do.
Next level is college. Woo-hoo!
Yeah.
Was there a moment where it was like, okay, this is a lot tougher than what high school was?
Yeah, it was. My freshman year, I actually wanted to transfer.
Why?
Was like, because it was hard.
Mm-hmm.
But my parents were kind of like, well, no, that's not what you're going to do. We're going to work at it. It was a conversation that was tough, but I'm glad we had it, and I'm glad I stuck with going to South Carolina.
The moment where you actually had that conversation, I mean, was it more to both of your parents?
It was a mixture of both, because I feel like my mom still lets me be a woman, like a girl at a time. She lets me grow up. She's like, yeah, go to prom, like, do those things. And my dad was more like, hey, you need to have a basketball in your hand, training.
Why you going to prom? You ain't got your bag.
Exactly.
What if they want to play at the prom?
Hope you going in the gym. Since it's going to be in the gym, you need to get ready. He's that type. So it was a healthy balance. He was like, hey, you going to be in the gym, babe. Get some shots up. And I'm like, wait a minute. I'm trying to have fun. Let me live.
You had a nice balance between the two.
Yes.
Your freshman year was a tough year. Was it sophomore year that things turned around? Did you get a better concept of it?
Yeah. I started learning a lot more about myself to handle it. But nothing was like my junior year when we won the national championship, hands down. Best year ever in college.
You were bragging just now, because I was going to get there. I was going to get to the time when you won a championship, and you went and threw it out there as if I didn't know.
I'm sorry, I just had to put you on notice.
I know that, but you did it as if I'm not prepared for this conversation, in which I am. And that was bragging. Before we get deeper into the conversation, I got to pay some bills. Okay. Right hand, please. All right, this episode of Cold as Balls is brought to you by Old Spice. Old Spice Deep Sea with Ocean Elements, antiperspirant. Right hand. Thank you.
Do they have lotion?
You got quite the... No, that's not it. Well, that's body wash. Here, I've never had to use lotion. Is it that bad?
You should have asked. When you was doing deodorant, you should have said something about that lotion.
Well, you know, what I'm looking at is... I got no excuse. With that being said, get in the tub. We're going to sit on the stool, okay?
You go first.
Don't tell me what to do. This is my show.
All right.
Oh, yeah. It's about to get real. It's about to get rough for you.
Okay.
Okay, what's your mindset going into this last year of college? What is this? What does this mean?
Get lit.
Okay, all right.
Tee up.
Okay, tee up. What is that?
Turn up.
Well, this ain't, what, this is not.
This is what we do in South Carolina, Spurs up.
I've been to South Carolina several times. It's the first time I've ever seen it.
Oh, well, you ain't been in the real South Carolina?
I'll go tomorrow. And when I go, I got a new thing that I do called get lit. Tee up. Asia told me. Tee up. Get lit.
There it is. Senior year, you know, I'm living life.
Mm-hmm.
I pledged an AKA.
What's that noise?
Skee-wee.
Okay.
Go ahead, you try to do it.
Wee-wee. Wee-wee.
What are you calling pigs?
Huh? Where my AKAs at? Wee-wee. AKAs, let me see you make some noise. You heard.
Don't
sound right.
Anyways, back to senior year, because that was horrible.
On campus, what's everybody's reaction when they see you?
It was cool. Everybody kind of knew. The teachers knew who you were, so like, you know, I could kind of. Had a game last night, you know, it's tough.
What does that mean? Oh, teach, I'm sore.
Some of the teachers be at my game. Some of them be like, look at Professor So-and-so.
Professor So-and-so, hey, maybe I'll give you the game ball.
Yeah.
You're a cheater.
I'm not a cheater.
You're a cheater.
I did the work.
Tell me the teacher's names right now.
Absolutely not. I ain't no snitch.
I'll take them all down. Tia. Dawn Staley.
That's like my second mom. She's so annoying, but I love her to death.
Mm-hmm.
We just really formed a great bond over the 4 years.
Did she ever talk about me? You know, we from the same city.
Yeah, I know. She ain't never mentioned you, though.
Never?
Mm.
You were probably too busy teeing up.
No, I mean,
probably stomping on the yard. How important was that relationship to you? His second mom.
That was one of the reasons why I went to South Carolina, because I wanted someone that looked like me, mm-hmm. that's been through things that I wanted to go through.
When you say look like you, what are you talking about?
A black woman.
Oh, I thought you were talking about tall.
No.
Sorry. Okay. Give me one of the best things that she ever told you.
She just be like, don't f up.
Ah.
And I feel like that's the best advice anybody can give me.
I got a little piece of advice for you. Don't f up.
Wow, thanks.
Yeah. So maybe you put me in that category as some of the best advice you've ever got.
I don't think so.
Well, too late, I said it. Let's keep moving on.
It sounded better.
Right now, we're going to the WNBA. Holy cow. How are you going to step up? How are you going to handle it?
When they say idols become your rivals,
ooh,
that's real shit.
I like that. Who's your idol?
I love Candace Parker,
mm-hmm.
Elena Deladon.
Mm-hmm. Who do you feel is one of your biggest rivals?
Myself, I'm my biggest rival.
Why do you keep, who are you, who's the attitude? Here's the next question.
Okay.
You get MVP. Holy schnickle-diddles.
What is that?
A big word for little people.
Mm,
yeah, sense. Why don't you mind your business? Thank
yeah,
you.
I never used that word.
Holy schnickle-diddles. You just got most valuable player in the league. Mentally, where are you at now?
I won it in the bubble, so I was mentally, I was like, I just want to get out the bubble.
Was it like a really crazy experience for you?
It was definitely different.
Yeah.
I love being around people that I love and having them support me. Not having that was awful.
You are an advocate for mental health.
Yeah.
How did that play, being in the bubble?
It was tough. I think that's when I really had to like dig deep and figure me out from within. In the bubble, I had no outlet. When basketball's normally my outlet, then I can go home and just disconnect. Mm-hmm. But in the bubble, it was just basketball, basketball, basketball. As athletes, we're still people.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think they see us as just machines because we're just out there working all the time and it's entertainment, okay, cool. But they tend to forget that we're people at the end of the day. That's the beauty of our league. Like, we're so unified in everything that we do. It's really like a sisterhood.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. At this point, we're going to get deeper into the tub because the conversation is about to get deeper as well. So take your stool out. Because here come the hard hitters.
Oh, God.
By the way, how impressed are you with this interview? I mean, it's really amazing.
It's really good. Bragging about yourself?
The way that I can navigate a conversation.
Wow.
Right? I used to do the same thing in basketball.
You played?
What do you mean, I played?
Do you have, like, pictures of this?
Right, crew? Talk to a 4-time Celebrity Game MVP. Thank you, right hand.
You said a what MVP?
Here you go, right hand. 4-time Celebrity Game MVP. What, Mrs. One MVP? What a loser! I love how some players in the NBA have made it a priority to support the WNBA.
It's super dope. They're really our brothers. And it's also something that we always tell when we have trolls coming after us. We're like, hey, your favorite player respects us.
Mm.
So at the end of the day, it's always good to have that cushion. And they're behind us 100%, whether it's decisions we make on just social justice things or just us being the phenomenal women that we are. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty cool just to have them always locked into us.
Within the world of basketball, what are other goals, expectations? Of course, a championship that has to be on the mind.
Yeah, that's right? The big one.
I don't know. Just being a legend, leaving that legacy.
Focus on the legacy.
That's it.
Getting drafted number one, going to Vegas. Do you gamble your money away?
No.
Mm-hmm. Nope. I'll find out.
Go ahead. Check
I the know book. The people.
That's cool.
Yeah. Okay. I can find out. Yeah. Easy thing. Oh God. No, I'm sorry, Daryl. Bam. Vegas. She's not. It's not about Chippendale. Oh, God. I'm sorry. They mistook the Vegas thing for Chippendales. No, guys, that's not. That's
like,
not,
Chippendale, like.
That's that they're thinking that the world of Vegas is about entertainment. No, that's not what this. No, Bam, I don't want to see that. Bam, don't do that. No one. No, Bam. Asia, I apologize.
I'm good.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. This is what we're going to have to live with, though.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, they take a gamble and they do what they feel our guests would appreciate.
Oh,
so you being in Vegas,
I get it.
This is a Chippendale experience that they're trying to provide. You're not even dressed like a stripper. You're dressed like a magician, idiot. This one here has a goddamn tuxedo jacket strapped to his chest. Might be one of the worst stripper outfits I've ever seen. Didn't do you justice.
You look nice.
And you're going to have to at least cover that mess up. And you know what I'm talking about. Talking about the nipples. Shouldn't be exposed. You get drafted. You're in Vegas.
Yeah.
Your coach is Bill Laimbeer.
Yep. Bad boy.
What's your mindset going to go play for Bill Laimbeer?
If he swing, I'm swinging.
Ooh. Ooh. What's your relationship with Bill Laimbeer?
Oh, no, that's my guy.
That's your guy.
Yeah.
You guys are very close?
Yeah. We get one hug a year. So that's, I guess no one thought that he could do that. And it's like a church. It's like a
vibe. It's not even a real hug.
Yeah, it's like a, all right.
I actually like that rule. Get your get out of here. Now go walk. I like that. You got a statue. I didn't talk about this. Me and you both.
Where's your statue? Where's yours?
Tyler.
Oh, okay, cool.
When you land, go over the bridge. And I'm going, I'm in the middle
like
of going.
This beat?
It's a life statue. How often do you go and look at your statue?
Not often.
Is it a good statue?
Oh, it's fire.
Yeah?
Like, my legs look incredible.
I mean, look, at this point, the... Okay. Okay. That's great.
Yeah.
I don't understand. Yeah. I don't understand why we have such a... Okay.
Oh, it's the strut. Hey. Ooh. 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 Yeah. I like it. Too much stomach.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, it's the hit. It's the belly slap for me. Okay. That was the one.
All right. That's great. That's great. Good job.
That's the one right there.
You'll be a big star, man. Okay. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to play a game of karaoke.
I don't know if you know this, but karaoke's like my game.
Well, all I can say is, you say it's your game, well, we soon will see. You against me.
Yeah.
That rhymed on purpose. It's karaoke time. Yeah. All right, Asia, you're going to go first.
Okay.
Then me.
Okay.
You're over here. Bam's got your stuff.
Oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh, how when the thunder in the number. Oh, when the saints go marching in. The saints are marching in.
Okay.
The saints are marching
it's
in. They marching in. They marching. They marching. Yeah, okay. They marching. Oh, when the saints go marching in.
Okay.
They...
I thought this was your game.
It is.
Because well,
I feel like
you did this don't make it good. This was stupid. music, please. Two, three, hit her. For he's a jolly good fella. I said, but he's a jolly good fella. Nobody
no
can deny. I said, nobody can deny. Nobody can deny. Nobody, nobody, nobody can deny. Yes. And when I tell you,
no.
And what? I said, I'm about to deny you a whooping. That's it. I said, cut it off.
Yeah.
Ma'am. No, no, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I swear. God damn it, man. To get your thick back out of here. You know what? I apologize. I apologize. I'm sorry. Okay, come on, one time. My God. Get your back. Get back. I'm so sick of your sick of everything you do. There's more where that came from. No, okay, that's enough. All right, crew, be the judge. If you think Asia won, make some noise. Sounds like a booing to me. If you like your job and you still want to work here, if you think I won, make some noise. I said, if you like your goddamn job.
Sounds like crickets.
Down, man. Well, it's clear. It's clear I did it again. Okay. I guess I'm the jolly good fellow. Lahooser. Well, that's it for this episode of Coldest Balls. I, of course, am your host, Kevin Hart. And Asia Wilson. Well, she joined me this episode. What an amazing talent she was. Outside of karaoke, boy, did she suck. Let's wrap it up with a good one. Hey, well, if I'm going to do what I used to do, if you get a boo,
no.
Asia sucks.
No.
MVP is it. But Kevin, I'm like Cameron, too legit to quit. Yeah! Give me another play at it.
That was terrible.
Huh? Hey, Asia.
No, you cheated.
Nobody can deny.
You cheated.
Down, bam. Tell them what it is.